capture the flag on standoff. Reborn with all to do, but all the pressure's still on enemy because they've got to finish this series off right here, and they have to get it done. And we'll see how they're going to go into it. What do you think of standoff as a capture the flag map, Ozzy?
I don't mind it. CTF ain't my favourite game type in this game, but I think standoff's a very good map for it. There's obviously a lot of routes you can pull it. You've got the straight route down the middle, which is obviously a 10-15 second cat, which can be very useful, especially late on in the game for them clutch cats. But then you've got routes round tracked and round back alley, which obviously is a longer cat route, but very tactical and lots of cut off. So we'll see a very well drilled team win this map, and let's see which one of our teams has got the best teamwork, the best chemistry, and can take out the W here.
No doubt about it. Here we go. Capture the flag standoff is about to get ready to get underway. This is, as I said, the potential last match between Reborn and Enemy. Enemy have to go for the final hit in this series to finish it off. However, still not over. Let's go on board with Reborn. It is their time to shine if they want to stay in this series. Let's go on board with Relentless War as we get ready to kick off Capture the Flag on standoff.
Secure the objective.
Yeah, they need to go big, and they can do with Relentless War with this AN really getting some big kills this game and hopefully pull up the streaks, because I think streaks are massive in this game. And as you can jump on board, just quickly on board with Phil. You see, he hasn't changed his streak, he's still got the RC car on. I wonder if that's a mistake or if he's got some hidden secret tactic up his hands with that one. But so let's jump on board with Psychotic Side. He's pushing the hill early. He's actually going to get killed by a Provo. And it's an early pull here, but it's easy shut down, and Reborn have pushed back to base.
Shevling gonna get the shutdown right here. War trying to get it done before getting taken out by Provo right there. A good early offense by Reborn, but nothing sadly coming out of it. The defense by Team Enemy was really well played there, but they need to keep it up consistently for the next 5 minutes in this round one, unless they can get a flag cap of their own. Provo getting the kill on Psychoticize right there. A little one-for-one exchange between the two teams. Provo gets another kill, extending himself to a four-kill streak right here. He's already stacking up the points, trying to go towards that first score streak. That could be very needed to get the first flag cap in this game here.
Yeah, I'm going to make a big call here, and I'm going to say that Team Enemy might win this just down to Provo's streaks alone. As they do, he's on board with Shevlin as he pulls the flag. He's alone, he's going to get a good kill. He's actually going to get shut down by Fuel, which is unlucky. But Provo getting shots for his six, and that's the start of his kill streak there. That comes in the Hellstorm. And I really think kill streaks in CTF are so important. You can do so much with them, and as long as he's alive, he's going to be a thorn in Reborn's side.
No doubt, Bowie right here, going to go on board with, stay on board with Provo, who's actually on a 6-kill streak, has the Hellstorm missile ready to go. The question is, when is he going to use it, and if so, will it be used offensively or defensively? We shall wait and see right here. Both teams, I'd say Enemy are being a lot more defensive compared to Team Reborn right here. It's going to see a 2-for-1 exchange for Team Enemy. Nice little exchange for him. Now 2-for-2. Both teams, as I said, really, really going for it. But right now, the advantage, you have to say, is really in favor of Enemy with that Hellstorm missile.
Yeah, you can see Enemy, they're not pushing up too hard. They're all sitting back. I think they may be playing for streaks. Like I say, streaks are so important. They've all got a very strong defensive setup here. No one's really pushing up, and they know they're 2-0 up in the map count. They know that they can take this map to take the series. So maybe they're just playing a bit defensive, trying out something new. Obviously, this isn't a competitive... Well, it's obviously a competitive map. It's a massive kill as Provo goes down. That's a huge kill from Psychoticize. He may not realise how big that kill really was for his team. They jump all the fuels. He's picked up three, and he's walking his way inside. He's actually going to get taken down. That's really unlucky. They jump all with... Who would you like to jump on board with, Shawnee?
Combo with Provo. Provo still going, although obviously lost that kill streak. He's going to wait. Let's see what he can do right here. He's been making plays pretty much all the way through this series, and this could be the biggest one of them all. If he can get this flag cap home, big pressure. Checking the van. Trying to shoot the van. He couldn't destroy it in time because Psychoticize gets a beautiful two piece. Nice return by him. We're now going to see the flag pulled by Shadow of Reborn.
Yeah, they're jumping board with Shad as he's taking it down track to size. The smokes are coming in. That's double smokes. And he's got a good setup here as he's going to get through.
Oh my.
He's got a real chance here. Is this going to be 1-0? He's actually going to go up top. Maybe there was players there. And that could be a good player. There are players down. But Provo, he's going to try and just jump this in.
Yes! brilliant. It was smashed. You know why, RB? Because he was told by his teammates they were rushing from the right side. He knew he had the air leverage. He leaps off. He gets it home. And this is what Rebo needed. A spark to light them up. And now they can try and go for two. If they can get the second flag cap, then well, oh well. There's still life in this series. And look at Shadow again. He's relentless. And now he's on the run, round the backside, past the meat, by the kebab shop. And now we're going to wait and see if he can keep going before getting taken out by Shelby. Brilliantly done by him, while Psychoticize gets a two-piece of his own. Now it's Tino on the run, before getting taken down. Both teams really, really going out of here, Ozzy.
Yeah, this is a really good round. Shelby is going to be four kills with the flag. That's his first streak, as he picks after this AN. And this is really good stuff. He's got to try and get the flag home, as obviously enemy are losing this. And they say kills don't matter in this game type, it's all about caps, and if he can get this home, that'll be 1-1 going to second half. Obviously he's got to try and take it home. If he's actually going to get hurt, I think he should be able to jump this in. Yep, that's going to be 1-1. And he's got full streak, that's going to be massive going to the second half.
No doubt about it. That's going to be a major, major factor. Shelvin, though, of course, that is, as you said, 1-1 on the scoreboard. It is a great show by both teams, but the key question, as you said, Ozzy, all streaks in favor of Shelvin. I keep calling him Shelvin. Shevlin, my apologies. He has a war machine, a lightning strike, and a hellstorm ready to go. And they could be the influencers to make them, as I said, either defend the flag or capture a flag. We'll wait and see. But a very strong round for both teams, both showing their capture the flag gameplay.
Yeah, I think it's all right to call him Shelvin at the moment because he's supporting his team lovely. He's going to pick up all them kills and he's going to get one flag cap, two returns. He's having a great game here. And like I say, streaks are massive in this game. And it's to say, if you use him obviously defensively, he's going to the war machine early and he's firing test shots down his right side. And he knows someone's in there, he's going to pick up a kill. It's actually jumping board with Estanbulum, he's pushing around for his fingers. Provo's going to pull and get killed straight away. Shevlin just marches in with that war machine and gets picked up by Relentless. DB kills death for Relentless.
Very nicely done indeed by Mr. Relentless. However, oh, I was about to say, Tina was on a 5-kill streak. It is going to get taken out though, and it is very, very interesting to see how Reborn go about this. Do they realize that the score streaks are going to be used by Shevlin? They should realize this because the war machine's been out already. Either way, 4 minutes and 14 to go in round 2, the final round, unless, of course, we get a stalemate and go into overtime, but more on that later if it does happen. Relentless War going to get the kill there on Mr. Provo. For the meantime, now with 4 minutes to go, it's going to be very interesting to see which team can force the advantage right here, because right now, both teams are really even.
Yeah, it's a very even map. Both teams are just having a lot of gun exchanges in the middle of the map. No one's really making a stand, pushing up. There's a big kill from Tino. He's standing bored with Tino. He's on this right side. He is hurt. His smoke's come down. And he's just going to... He's actually seen Scott Sides in the box. He's going to be able to pick up that kill. He pushes him. And actually, his actually teammate's going to clean up. That's another kill from Provo. And he still has that Hellstorm. And Shevlin's still with all his streaks. I said that streaks will win this game. And Reborn have none of them.
And no doubt, but they can still get it done. They managed to get a flag cap earlier on in round 1, and when it was 2 minutes to go against the runner play, you have to feel without any score streaks in their possession. But look at Reborn Fuel right here. Look at the strategy he's playing here. He's trying to be sneaky, trying to get in for the flag. He has been spotted though. It isn't going to quite work out for him right there. It's a nice strategy. And look at Shevlin actually getting a 3 kills right there with the lightning strike. Not in 2 kills with lightning strike, 1 with the M8A1. It's going to be very interesting to see how Reborn defend against this, because they should realize that there is a member of Team Enemy over by that green tank. Ah, and as I say, there he goes down.
Yeah, so he's announced his streaks. Obviously, he pulled out the war machine because they knew he had streaks and he used that lightning strike. And obviously, he tried using it in an offensive fashion. That's quite hard to say. But he, and they didn't get the flag out. But he's actually going to pull the flag himself. And he's looking over to Kebab, but I believe they may be spawning behind him from Tractor, as he's actually going to get through well. And he's actually going to pick up
Brilliantly done, man.
Yeah, that's real good stuff as he's taking it round. He's going to set one. Oh, that's a huge kill right there.
Brilliant.
That's a huge kill.
Fantastic stuff by Mr. Shevlin, and that is 2-1, and that is the man who we've made reference to along with Provo. With all due respect to Tino and Stefan, these two guys have been making plays, and Shevlin is going to be the man to do it. 2-1 on the scoreboard, all streaks ready to go again. Will he put them to use efficiently, and will it stop Reborn from capturing it to tie it up? Fantastic play by Shevlin right there.
Yeah, if you pull up the scoreboard, you'll see Shevlin and Provo both 19, both with less deaths. And as you can see, Shevlin, 2 captures, 2 returns. So not only is he getting all the kills, he's getting all the cats. And that's he's using that war machine on his flag defensively. And he's been a real good asset to this team. He's making massive plays. And Reborn have got an answer with something. They've got to do it soon.
Out about it, and Shevlin right here around the backside of the alleyway. He is going to get the kill there on Reborn Fuel around by that backside petrol station. 1:07 to go. It is up to Team Reborn to get a flag cap here. If they do not, this series is over with a 3-0 whitewash. But it can still be salvaged. They need to force something right here. They just need to go all in on us. They need to just rush all together as a team, in my opinion. Anyway, what do you think they have to do, Ozzy?
They've got to go all out. They've got to go. Billy Big Guns, Terry Big Taters, they've got to do something, can they? They've got to do something special. 40 seconds left, they've got streaks against them. They need Psycho with the MP7, he's got to run in there, he's got to pull some flags, and they've got to do something. There's 30 seconds left on the clock. They stand board with Psycho as he's pushing the flag. A helper storm's gonna come in.
Oh no, this is not good for Team Reborn. 20 seconds to go, I'd say it takes around about 12 seconds to pull this flag. They need to get it right now and make the rush through the middle. It could still be done, maybe less than that, but it has to be said, Team Enemy are going to close out this amateur showcase with a 3-0 show in the, best of 5, and it has to be said, all of the games apart from Search and Destroy were really, really well fought. Both Capture the Flag and CTF could have gone any way, but the Search and Destroy rightfully won there by Team Enemy. A really nice show by both teams.
Yeah, that was really close. Really close yet again, and obviously Enemy was the win to make it 3-0 in the series. And let's play out the... I want to play out the last two maps to see if Reborn can get themselves some honour and pull out these back two maps.
Okay, so we're going to go on to... Okay, we're going to play the last two because there is realistically nothing on the line apart from, of course, a little bit of pride. And Reborn are going to look to get in a bit of practice, so we'll be bringing you the next two maps in just over 3 minutes. You guys know of the maps, of course. It is Hap on Yemen and Search and Destroy Raid.